All right, guys, so today we're gonna do a pretty intense 8-minute workout. We're gonna do 8 exercises for a minute each, and we're gonna rest 10 seconds in between each exercise. So, you know, I'm outdoors. I would challenge you to actually do this workout outdoors. The weather here in Orlando, Florida is really nice right now, so you might have inclement weather, being that it is December in most places. Well, in all places it's December. But here it's sunny, it's about 76 degrees right now. So if you can do it outside, do it outside. Even if you have to put your mittens on or your jacket, you know, just get outside and just get a change of scenery. Get out, you know, get from outdoors. But if you can't, do it inside in the comfort of your own home. Maybe do the workout looking out the window. You know, I think that's a fair compromise. So anyway, let's get started. We're gonna start off with the jumping jacks.
Jumping jacks for 1 minute.
All right, let's go, boom. Make sure you pace yourself. Keep that core engaged throughout the whole movement and throughout each exercise. We want a strong core, guys. Pace yourself. My modification would be this, right? Because as long as we're moving and breathing, we're working, and that's fitness, okay? So go at your own pace, go at your own fitness level, and just move and breathe. That's all I ask. We got 30 more seconds. Keep it up, keep it going. For me, I'm able to look around. I see kids in the distance playing outside at recess to the right of me. I got a couple playing tennis. Got people walking their dogs right there. So this makes me happy. Being outside makes me happy. Sometimes you just gotta do what makes you happy. You gotta find your own happiness. No one can give it to you. All right, so being outdoors makes me happy. All right, 10 second break. All right, so basically what we're gonna do now, we're gonna go into alternating lunges. We're gonna do it for a minute. Ready? Let's go.
Alternating lunges for 1 minute.
Make sure you don't slam that knee into the ground and don't allow that lead knee to track too far or beyond your toes. Just keep it as natural as possible. Keep that core tight and engaged. Keep your torso upright. Just like that, boom. Let me show you what it looks like from the side. Slight modification. Don't go down as deep. Let's still go through the motion, but you know, don't go down as deep. All right, let's go. We got about 20 more seconds. I like to keep my hands on my hip. You don't have to, you can, if you want to, put them out here, but it reminds me to keep my core engaged. So that's why I like to do it like this. Kind of keeps me in check. Boom. I'm gonna rest here in 3 seconds. All right, rest for 10 seconds. Shake it off if you need to. Now we got push-ups. So you can do the modified push-up, or you can do the full push-up. And I'll show you each one. So the modified version. Like that, right? And if you wanna take a break, well really, the modified version, there is no break. But this is a regular push-up. Try to keep those elbows as close to your body as possible. You take a break in this position right here. Then get right back to it. Keep that core tight. Keep your back neutral. Don't have your head down like this. Don't have your head up like this. Keep everything nice and neutral. Turn back around this way now. Pace yourself. Next exercise, you're gonna feel it in your arm. So I'm just giving you forewarning. Each one of these exercises feeds into the next exercise or the corresponding exercise.
Three.
Just be ready. Get one more in. Boom. Right. So next one's the plank touch. Like I said, those arms, they're gonna get their money's worth. So you ready? Let's go. You get in the plank position. Body's nice and neutral, back's flat, just gonna reach. Modification, you can come down to this plank position and reach. I don't really think this is easier, actually I think it's harder, so I'm gonna go back up. You can take a break in this position. But I don't want you doing this. I want that body, that back, everything neutral, spine, everything, I want it flat. I want you to reach like you're trying to grab something.
Those arms are burning, guys.
That's what we want. They say pain is weakness leaving the body. I hope they're right, because I'm feeling a little pain, and I'm feeling a lot of weakness. Just kidding, guys. If you feel pain, like an unnatural amount of pain, make sure you stop. But you're going to feel, let's call it a burn. We won't call it pain. It's people, when they hear the word pain, it doesn't sit too well with them. So we'll just call it a burn. So now we'll do wall sits for 1 minute. So you want to form a 90 degree angle with your legs. So you don't want to be like this. You want to be like this. And don't rest your body weight on your knees, on your legs. You want to be upright. And as if you're going to lean, you want to make sure that you keep your back neutral. So you can have your hands out like this, or you can just have them to your side. I'm going to alternate because I do feel the burn in my legs. So just keep that back neutral though, guys. It's beautiful out here. I don't know if y'all can really see, but it feels good. It's real nice out. So we got about 15 more seconds. All right, just hold it. Keep that core tight and engaged throughout the movement or the non-movement. Let it come to you. All right, we're gonna rest for 10 seconds. Then we'll go right to the Russian twist, which is my least favorite of the exercises. But at the end of the day, guys, it works. Let's go. It's almost like you're transitioning something from one side to the other. Really engage that core. Really work those obliques. You're gonna feel it in your quads. You wouldn't think that this works your legs, but this works your whole body. And if you don't have a lot of cushion back there, make sure that you get you a mat or something. I have a little cushion back there, so me being on this concrete doesn't affect me much. But whew, starting to feel it. Got about 20 more seconds. Let's work it out. Whew. Keep that core tight. That's what's gonna give you your balance. Got about 10 more seconds. Make sure you're breathing. Don't hold your breath. Next, mountain climbers. We made it through the Russian twist. Now it's time to climb that mountain. I'm gonna turn this way so you can see how to do a correct mountain climber. See? Start in the plank position I like to, and then try to keep my back in that same position, nice and neutral, so I don't have my head down here. I don't need to see my feet or my legs. I know where they are. I'm gonna keep my neck neutral. I'm just gonna go. You can go fast if you want to, but pace yourself, because we want to do it as efficiently as possible. We're not trying to, I did a video talking about the form police, so we want to have as good a form as possible. This is going to give us optimal results, right? Take a break in this position, but as long as you're moving, and you're not hurting yourself or putting yourself in a situation where you can be injured, all good. Moving and breathing is fitness. We got about 7 more seconds. Ooh, I feel it in my core, guys. My ass. Rest for 10 seconds. Now we're down to the final exercise, which is the curtsy lunge. I put this last on purpose because it gives us opportunity to let our heart rate come back down, to focus on what you're going to do for the rest of the day. For me, I'm gonna go and have my first meal of the day. Then I got some work to do as far as programming for my clients and just getting things in order with my business. So I want you to take this minute to think about what you're gonna do. Make sure that you congratulate yourself for getting through this workout. And I guarantee you guys, just 8 minutes, 5 minutes a day, you're gonna see the results, because it's gonna translate into other areas of your life. If you have discipline and you're consistent, whatever you can see, you can touch, you can hold, right? All right, guys, so we got about 10 more seconds. Nice and easy, let that heart rate come down. Take deep breaths. One. We did it. We got through the 8-minute workout. Now that wasn't too bad. I'm feeling good. I'm feeling refreshed, but I'm not like, let me stop this. I'm not totally exasperated, you know, like I still have energy. And with this workout, you can take a minute to 2 minutes off and do it again. And I say do it up to 3 times. And that'll hit you, what, 8 times 3, 24 minutes. I like to keep my workouts 24 minutes and below. So as long as you're working, as long as you're moving and breathing, that's fitness. Always go at your, you know, at your fitness level. Don't look at what I do or look at the next person and try to compete or try to do what they're doing. Follow your own path. Let me guide you, you know, as it pertains to fitness and health and nutrition, but at the same time, you have to be on your own path, guys. So we did it, it's done. I'm feeling good, congratulations. If you want to see more videos like this and you haven't subscribed to the YouTube channel yet, be sure to subscribe, Abs-matic. YouTube.com/Abs-matic. Share the video, subscribe, leave a comment. Definitely hit that like button, guys. And until next time, be now, be you, be free, be great, and let's build together.